Now, I got two women in my family, and I face the double team all the time. Since I was 7 years old, I've seen a psychiatrist. She has forced me into the mental hospital twice. So pretty much since I was a young child, it's been a burden. And anytime either one of these two women get mad at me, the go-to answer is, you're gonna end up just like your father. And don't you lie to me and say you never said that, because you have.
Wait. Talk to me, not them. Because I take your life very seriously.
I appreciate that.
I mean, I really do. I have two sons. Robin and I have been married 40 years. We've got two sons about your age. And when I was preparing for this show over the last several days, I really asked myself what impact it would have on either or both of my boys if at 15 I just disappeared. I think when that happened, that hurt you a lot.
I would agree.
And I think the circumstance under which he left and the condition in which you found him when you sought him out, where he was homeless, delusional, hallucinating, and disoriented, scared you to death.
Of course, it was the scariest thing I've ever seen in my life.
I think it scared you for you because you do have a BA in psychology. And I know that when you did that, you found out that there is a genetic component to psychosis and schizophrenia. And so a big part of you has got to be thinking, is this a ticking time bomb in me?
Yeah, because I wouldn't say it actually had an onset in his life until he was in his early 30s. And I haven't made it that far yet.
A big part of you does feel like, for whatever reason, he did abandon you.
Maybe in his head, he felt like he was so helpless that leaving would save his family.
But you're still alone, aren't you?
For now.
And that hurts.
It would hurt anybody.
Yeah, and it hurts you. But people respond to these things in a lot of different ways. And one way is to go through life like this, with an attitude that says, get them before they get me. You know, having a chip on your shoulder, being caustic, being arrogant, keeps you from getting hurt because you don't ever let anybody get close to you. And behind all of that, you're wondering if you're going to wake up tomorrow and not know the difference between reality and fantasy.
What is it, like a light switch? On and off? It just clicks?
No. I'm going to answer that question. Is that you believe, and I think you're probably right, that your father is afflicted with some form of psychosis, probably some form of schizophrenia from what's been described. Now, I don't know him. I'm not diagnosing him. But from what everybody describes, it sounds like that he probably is experiencing schizophrenia. It is true that there is a genetic component to that. But I'm going to tell you, and I want you to really, really hear me. Are you focused and paying attention here? Because this is really important.
I'm ready.
Okay, don't be thinking about something else. This is critical that you understand this. And I'll say it to you five times if you need me to, because I really want you to understand this. Blake, it's so important. When it comes to something like mental illness and schizophrenia, genetics tell us who can be afflicted with schizophrenia, depression, or whatever, not who will be. It tells us who can be, not who will be. It tells us who might be predisposed.